This employee scheduling workbook is built to be a flexible tool for creating weekly work schedules. Schedules can be fully customized to suit 1 to 3 working shifts for up to 100 employees in either 4 or 6 week scheduling blocks. The workbook can be filled with your own employee information, including employment type and employee role. Schedules automatically tally the number of required workers, and a convenient dashboard provides a breakdown of the hours included in each work schedule. When first using the workbook, you should enter employee information and select preferences before creating a work schedule. In order to begin, select the Lists tab at the bottom of the workbook. The first table on this sheet is the Employee Summary table. This table is where you'll enter the employee names you'd like to be available for selection when creating a work schedule. In addition to names, you can also enter employment type and employee role for each employee in the table. To choose the employee roles available for selection, you can use the Employee Role Types table to the right of the worksheet. In order to set up your own employee roles, you can either replace an existing entry or type a new entry into the next blank row of the table. The final section of this sheet is the Weekday Format option. This setting determines how weekdays are displayed on the schedule, and it can be set to one of the 3 options by using the drop-down menu at the top of the table. After you finish setting up the list sheet, select the Settings sheet at the bottom of the workbook. This sheet is where you can select your preferences for how you'd like the work schedule to be displayed. Here you can use the checkboxes to determine the number of scheduled shifts and choose between 4 and 6 week scheduling blocks. The number of employee slots on the schedule is also selected on this sheet by choosing an option from the drop-down menu. Every available slot on the schedule doesn't need to be filled, so select the option that will provide enough total spaces to meet your schedule's needs. Once you've set up your preferences, you can create a schedule by selecting the Schedule tab at the bottom of the workbook. This tab is where work schedules are created. Before creating your first schedule, you have the option to replace the company name and company logo placeholders with your own company information. If you'd like to add your company's logo to the schedule, delete the placeholder image and select the Insert tab at the top of the workbook. From here, select the Pictures icon and select This Device on the menu that appears. In the File Select window, navigate to the location of your company's logo, select the logo file, and click the Insert button to load the image into the workbook. Once you've resized the logo as needed, drag the image to fit in place above the scheduling table. Now that we've finished setting up the workbook, it's a good idea to save the workbook file before creating your first schedule. To begin creating a schedule, enter the date of the Monday you'd like to mark the beginning of your work schedule. The correct dates will be automatically generated, and you can enter the required daily workers by editing each day's People Required field located at the bottom of each shift schedule. To add an employee to the schedule, select an employee name using the drop-down menu located in the far left column of the shift table. For each selected employee, the corresponding employment type and role are automatically pulled into the schedule. Daily work hours for each employee are entered by filling out the corresponding date within each employee's row of the table. As hours are entered, the Days field will adjust to show how many days the employee is scheduled to work on this shift's work schedule. As the schedule is filled out, the Total People and Needed People fields at the bottom of the shift schedule will be automatically calculated. Repeat this process as needed in each shift table in order to complete your personalized work schedule. If you'd like to clear the work hours and create a new schedule, select the Clear Schedule button at the upper left-hand corner of the worksheet. This action will clear daily hours from all shift schedules, but will keep employee information and the number of required people for each weekday and work shift. The final portion of the workbook is the dashboard, which can be viewed by selecting the Dashboard tab at the bottom of the workbook. This sheet provides a summary of the information entered into the current work schedule. The first table in the group of tables on the right displays total daily work hours by work shift. The following 3 tables below provide additional summaries of total work hours by both employee role and work shift. The final table in the dashboard displays total weekly work hours for each employee included in the work schedule. When an employee has totaled more than 40 work hours within a single week, their total hour count will be highlighted. Just as with the scheduling sheet, you have the option to replace the company name and company logo placeholders with your own company's information. This can be done in the same manner previously demonstrated on the schedule sheet. This concludes the overview of the Employee Scheduling Workbook. If you'd like to review any of these instructions, a summary can be found on the Introduction tab in the bottom left corner of the workbook.